armpit area has taken an absolute battering.
And red. Five rounds, Mitch. Cautious start.
Nong-O's immediately starting to faint. He's starting to throw that low kick just to see what Suzuki's going to do. He knows Suzuki's a wild card. Ooh, he attacks that lower leg with that nice low kick. He goes up top, mixing the strikes.
Very swift kick to the head. That was no time for Suzuki to bring that arm up and block it. Lightning fast.
Everything Nong-O is going to do is going to have a purpose, just to see what Suzuki, how he reacts, how he handles these shots, what he does when he throws that leg kick.
Both very muscular men at bantamweight. And again, Nong-O goes up expertly with the kick.
Nice jab landed by Suzuki there.
Oh, that was heavy. Heavy blow to the chest.
This is what Suzuki can't do. He can't allow Nong-O to start getting these reads on him. Seeing how he reacts, getting comfortable, starting to land these shots. Because every single one of these things he's starting to put the puzzle together.
If you haven't seen it before, what is immediately apparent is Nong-O's speed, both with legs and hands. Sends in that right hand, and then it recoils before you even know it landed. That's what Suzuki faces tonight.
Nice body kick landed by Nong-O.
He's been in absolutely buoyant mood all day, Suzuki. When the athletes came into the circle to warm up several hours ago, he was buzzing around, doing mixed martial arts move on his coach. Right hand from Nong-O and follows it up with a kick. That little teep kick, looking to plant itself just above Suzuki's right knee, looking to hyperextend it. And then he comes back with the thudding, bruising kick to the side of the ribcage.
Nong-O's gone 3-0 here in one Super Series en route to this first title defense. He looks stupendous against Fabio Pinca. Captured a unanimous decision victory over him. Mehdi Zatut again. And then to win the belt against Hong Zihao. Really put on a tremendous performance.
10-point must system. So this opening round is crucial. And Nong-O almost upends his opponent with that kick to the right leg of the Japanese athlete. Suzuki bounces right back into range though. But when he does, he just eats these kicks. And look at the guard, then go headhunting. But look how red Suzuki's left arm is. He's already taken a bit of a battering there.
So I think that's something they see.
Solid. Suzuki had his back to us, couldn't quite see where that landed, but it looked as if it was square on the jaw. And similarly struck there. Might have got his arms in the way, Suzuki. Keeps coming forward though, the Japanese man, doesn't he? No backing off in him tonight. Speed at which Nong-O unleashes.
Go! Go!
A little bit of an embarrassed grin there as Nong-O bounces straight back up to his feet.
I don't think I've ever seen a smile as scary as Nong-O. The jubilation coming out of his face right now just looks ecstatic to be throwing these shots.
Just look at the left shoulder blade of Suzuki. It is reddened, there's little blotches there. That's a measure of the punishment that he's taking up high on his shoulder blade, not to mention on his legs. There's the exact kick that I'm talking about.
You know,
and again.
A lot of this has to do with the complexion of Suzuki's skin tone. He is quite pale. A tan might help in that area a little bit, but we are starting to see that just the power that Nong-O possesses. He's delivering some tremendous, thunderous shots.
But look at the welts there, Mitch.
Yeah.
He's being marked.
Yeah, those left kicks would mark up anybody. I think they'd mark up an oak tree.
Ferocity from Nong-O, and he keeps going. The accuracy as well.
The way that he's catching him underneath the armpit,
yep,
right on the lat right there.
So he's countering a left-handed punch.
It looks like he's got a sack full of hamburger and a headlock. It just looks, look at his armpit.
It's crazy. So what Suzuki is doing is when that kick comes flying in, he's lifting his left arm to protect his head, but then he's exposing his shoulder blade and his armpit. And that's what's getting battered at the moment. 44 seconds left of the second round, and Nong-O is putting on an exhibition of kicking here. That right leg working overtime. And the extent to which Suzuki is going to be able to lift that left hand for the rest of this contest is starting to worry his corner man, I should think.
You can see the way that Suzuki's starting to shake out those hands. That body kick's just going to pay some serious dividends as this match progresses.
Oh, and that's finally made him stumble, and it landed in exactly the same spot. How many times has he hit that spot? There it is again. It must be in the order of 20 in this round. Chose to stand again between rounds. Nong-O had a little bit of a rest. Suzuki was there for the entire 1 minute, standing up, taking advice, taking some water.
That's the thing, Suzuki has a tremendous gas tank. He never gasses. He has the ability to throw serious shots with 100% power and not get tired. But at this point, I think he's just kind of mesmerized at Nong-O right now. He's just standing in front of him, eating these kicks.
And it's getting predictable, isn't it? Every single one of those blows, absolute pinpoint accuracy in precisely the same place every time. There it is again. Two more examples for you. Goes downstairs. Why not vary things a little bit? Suzuki is just being taken apart at this stage. And surely, Mitch, at some point, it's going to be difficult to do anything useful with that left arm of his.
Well, Suzuki is incredibly tough, you know, so I just think it's the power of Nong-O. But it's not like he's not eating a lot of these on the arm. So I think his arm is going to be okay. But what's going to happen is his lat is going to just start to fail him. And that's a huge muscle involved in throwing that right hand. So a lot of the power comes from the entire posterior side of your body. So he's not going to be able to generate any power off of that side, because he's just taking a hammering right now.
What a thudding he is given there to Suzuki. And he's varying the shots now slightly more. Every time Suzuki comes forward, and let's give him credit, he has not stopped coming forward, but every time he does, Nong-O just picks him off.
But now he's starting to go up top, so that hand might be starting to drop a little bit. Nong-O sees it, and now he's starting to go headhunting.
Finally, he caves and collapses slightly. 48 seconds left of this third round.
Man, I'm just cringing looking at the damage accumulating on the side of his body.
Just overwhelmed by the repeated accuracy. There it is again, absolute pinpoint stuff. Once more for you.
Because Suzuki, he's trying to block the headshot. He knows that Nong-O is looking for the head kick, but he gets his hand up and that completely exposes the entire left side of his body.
And just there while you were speaking, Suzuki tried to throw a kick, landed, but got absolutely punished with Nong-O's right hand. Oh. It seems he has no choice but to just be a passenger in this contest. Nong-O putting on an exhibition. 40, 50.
Stop. It's just superficial damage, I think, at this. Actually, probably not. It's probably accumulated. But he doesn't seem to be. It doesn't seem to be affected too much by it. He's still throwing shots. He's still coming forward. But this is definitely working its way up into accumulated damage, which is the second highest.
It's got to limit his
damage
movement.
Category.
As you said, it's such a big muscle to target. It's tenderized like a hamburger now. Nong-O just seems relaxed.
Go!
His movement smooth, lightning fast. Both feet and hands.
Yeah, we're seeing the culmination of decades of experience, 300 plus matches, multi-time world champion. This is what it looks like. This is what Muay Thai clinic is.
And you have to assume that this was the game plan from the beginning, in which case, expertly executed.
Well, that's what he told me. He says he wants to throw that right kick. He wants to destroy the body. He wants to throw those feints, and he's doing exactly what he said.
And despite the wreck that Suzuki's left shoulder is, he just threw a big left hand. And I have to say, didn't seem particularly limited in his movement. Must give credit to Suzuki for continuing to stand there and continuing to come forward.
But the hand is starting to come down a little bit, but it's hard to tell if this is accumulated damage or just superficial.
Combination of the two.
Suzuki's tough as nails, man. You got to hand it to the guy. He is taking every shot and wearing them well.
Suzuki is just putting on an absolute show here. Even got his hands up beautifully well there to stop that thudding left hand that came in from Suzuki. Defensively, perfect, but he hasn't really had to do a great deal in that regard. It's all about Nong-O's offense. There it is again. ...45 seconds left in the fourth round. There might be a little bit of frustration creeping into Nong-O's work, because Suzuki just keeps coming forward. Of the two, it's Suzuki who's going backwards.
Yeah, I don't think he looks too frustrated to me. He looks pretty relaxed and calm out there. Everything he's throwing is landing. He's not trying to land head kicks. He's not trying to throw, you know, big right-handed shots, trying to end, you know, trying to finish Suzuki. It seems like he has a very specific target, and he's just trying to hammer it home.
Still throwing punches. Suzuki right, left, right just now. Don't think any of them got through that very staunch guard of Nong-O.
Left side of his body, you know, you wouldn't, his face is fine. He looks okay.
The almost compulsory, and by the way, it totally isn't, show of respect at the start of that round. So common to see and beautifully exhibited by these two. Final stanza then. And Nong-O will not repel. He keeps going, keeps coming, keeps throwing. Tremendous speed, ridiculous accuracy. Suzuki will not back off. He's come forward for the entire contest, but now he's getting stopped in his tracks a bit. Nong-O has stepped up the pace, and this crowd are behind him. Every blow mirrored. Goes downstairs as well and back up, this time to the head, so slightly higher than the vast majority of his kicks with that very busy right leg. Final 2 minutes. Go ahead, Mitch.
You can see Suzuki's trying to keep that elbow tight to his body just to deflect some of the shots, but that's when those head kicks are sneaking through.
It's been a clinic, hasn't it?
Nong-O disguises his kicks really well, so it's hard to tell what exactly he's aiming for, whether he's going to go to the legs, whether he's going to the body, whether he's going to the lat, or if he's going headhunting.
Yeah, it looked like there was a little accidental clash of heads there, and I think both of them got marked.
That elbow landed nicely to the head of Suzuki.
There's a cut on Suzuki's forehead.
I think that's from that elbow.
Yeah. I think the mark I can see on Nong-O's head is actually just Suzuki's blood. Spinning back elbow. And Suzuki smiles at him. And you've got to give this Japanese man all the credit for lasting the whole distance, providing the entertainment and the resilience.
Yeah. Nong-O Gaiyanghadao is definitely showing what has made him one of the world's best strikers. And Suzuki's in there. He's definitely in every single aspect of this match. He's trying to push forward. He's just taking so many shots. He's tough as nails, though. But
you have to feel for anyone on the ONE Championship roster looking to compete in Muay Thai's bantamweight division, watching this one and thinking to themselves, if I want the strap, I've got to get by this guy. Something else. Final 20 seconds. Lap it up, fight fans. Up to the head. Little bit untidy from Suzuki. Can't blame him at this stage. Fatigue is setting in. Nong-O rounding off what has been a near perfect performance. Pinpoint accuracy.